Hi, I have again encountered one question regarding how do we study biochemistry. So basically, I just want to say that biochemistry, how much ever you read, if you read it 10 times also, you're not going to remember it because it is very volatile subject. If you read today also, you will not remember it by today evening what you have done. So it is very volatile, and that is why basically, if you have read one page, you don't remember it, and then you stop reading the subject. Believe me, even in my MD, I found it to be very volatile. When I was doing my post-graduation in biochemistry, I found it to be a very volatile subject. Doesn't help much. It is a volatile subject. You have to keep on reading it. But the point is that in first MBBS, anatomy will take most of the time. 60% of the time goes into studying anatomy. The rest 40% of the time goes in physiology. So basically, you're left with zero time for biochemistry. And because it is a volatile subject, you do not remember it and you do not have time. So you completely ignore biochemistry. So, first thing, remember you have to pass biochemistry. Passing is the most important thing. The second thing is good marks. If you want to get good marks, you have to study it. But you have to pass biochemistry, for which you should know what are the important topics. You have to pass biochemistry. But the question is, first, you don't remember it. Second, it is volatile. Third, you don't have time. And fourth, very important question, is biochemistry really important in MBBS, in medical, in dental? Is it really important? See, biochemistry has only cycle, cycle, and cycle. So you think you are in MBBS, you are in healthcare related facility, you should know about the drugs given to the patient, you should know about the diseases. So why study this biochemistry? See, you're made up of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen. What you eat is carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen. And these metabolism, if it is wrong somewhere, if the cycle is wrong somewhere, it will lead to some disease. Second, there are enzymes which increase in certain diseases. So, if you don't know why biochemistry is important, you will not read it and you will not become good in medicine. Biochemistry is the basis of medicine. You should know what is ALT, what is AST, and when it is raised. Studying disease will not help that much because you should have a background of biochemistry to know what is the diagnostic behind going on in the liver. What is increased in jaundice? What is not increased in jaundice? Why conjugated bilirubin will come only in that type of jaundice? Why unconjugated bilirubin will come only in that type of jaundice? You have to learn all this, and that is why biochemistry is important. So now, how do you learn? First is books. You have Satyanarayan, Vasudevan, Lippincott, and Harper. I strongly recommend Satyanarayan for first MBBS students because I read that. Vasudevan, I haven't read so much. Lippincott, Harper are the books that I have read afterwards in post grad, but not in undergraduate. If you are doing Lippincott, it is good because the cycles have been explained well, but it does not cover the entire biochemistry. If you are reading Harper, I'll tell you don't have time. So please just see how to manage time properly. So these are the things. Basically, you will have books, but you will not read. Second is teacher and notes. Most of the time, biochemistry class, nobody is taking. The second thing is that if somebody is taking, you are not making notes or you are bunking. Or the third thing is that you are sleeping. But I'll advise, just remember at least which topic which teacher is taking, because that will be very important in your viva. Because generally, the teachers ask those questions only in the viva, what they have taught. Friends, group discussion is the most important thing, but that we utilize only for anatomy. We utilize it for bones, artery, nerves, veins, their roots, but nothing that sort for biochemistry and mnemonics. So the thing you can do is you can make mnemonics, discuss with your friends, and it will be very helpful. Now, internet in that YouTube. In YouTube, there are plenty of videos you can use for biochemistry to learn them. But I would suggest to chalk out a few and do from there, and not to waste time on just searching for the videos. See, I started with my YouTube channel when I did completed my post graduation, and I did it only to actually as a thank you gesture for to my students and from my to my teachers. That is why I started the channel. So because I thought students are not doing biochemistry well, my batch to which batch I was teaching was not doing it up to the mark. So I wanted to take up the topics and I wanted to help the other batches too. So I started with it. So there are many videos, you choose whatever you want, but personally I like Shomu's Biology, though not a biochemistry channel, but some certain specific videos are very nice. He does it very nicely. And then there are biochemistry songs. Basically they have a rhythm to learn, memorize the cycle, so it helps. The old fashioned thing to learn the cycle is first read the diagram from the book, then draw the diagram in your book, see it repeatedly, see it in the morning for 5 minutes, see it in the evening for 5 minutes. But you have to see and then read the theory after you have done with the cycle. Don't read the cycle and read the theory together. First read the cycle, draw the cycle, keep on continuously seeing that one cycle for 3-4 days, then read the theory behind it and repeat it. Repeat this thing again and again. You have to repeat because the subject is very volatile. Now if you ask me uronic acid pathway, I would not be able to tell you. And I was asked uronic acid pathway, I had to say the pathway in my MD exam, Viva. I had to say it, not even write it, I had to say it. So it becomes very difficult. See, people say you have to know the concept to remember biochemistry. And I differ in this. First MBBS, if you start searching for concepts of biochemistry, you will lose on time. I feel memorize, memorize and memorize. Memorizing is the key. Do learn, repeat biochemistry. You learned your tables of maths when you were a kid. You have to learn the cycles of biochemistry now, so that it is helpful afterwards. Biochemistry is more than cycles, but unfortunately our first MBBS syllabus is made in such a way that we only see cycles. So yeah, for first MBBS, read the cycles, repeat the cycles, draw the cycles, and if so, make a drawing book and keep it. And one tip I would like to say, maintain that drawing book till the end of your MBBS, because you can put small MCQs over there that will help in your PG exam. So if you have a book with you ready, it will help you till you have completed with your post graduation. Okay, memorize the subject. Thanks a lot.